In this video, we're going to look at converting a quadratic from general form to what is known as vertex or standard form. This form here, y equals x minus h squared, squared plus k. Now there's no a in here because a is just 1 on this one. We're going to use a technique called completing the square. So first thing we want to do is group our terms. So I'm going to rewrite my quadratic, so it's y equals x squared plus 4x. Then I'm going to add something, and I'm going to subtract something, and then I'll have a plus 7 at the end. Now the question is, what's going to be added and subtracted? These are going to be the same number in both places. The way we determine it is from this b term from our quadratic. Because the way this is going to work, we'll kind of go down to the next step. We're going to rewrite this as a perfect square. So these three terms here are going to be our perfect square and factor into something plus something, the quantity squared. Now, this will always be x. The sign here determines the sign here. If this is plus, then this is plus. If this were minus, then this would be minus. The number that goes here is exactly half of this number every time. So we cut 4 in half and we get 2. So the question is, what goes up here? Well, we take this number and we square it. 2 squared is 4. So we put a 4 there and there. And if we look, x squared plus 4x plus 4 factors into x plus 2, the quantity squared. Now we have to take care of this part here as well. We have a negative 4 plus 7, so plus 3, and we are now in vertex form. We can now look at this as a shift of the graph of y equals x squared. What's nice about that is it makes it easy to identify the vertex because it's shifted left 2 because of this here, and shifted up 3. So we know that this quadratic will have a vertex at the point negative 2, comma 3.